AIDS, you are so bad. You destroy homes and marriage. We must stop your atrocities. We won't be your victims.
The truth of it is nobody needs to die. We don't need to die if we have access to treatment. We are not waiting for death. Believe me, I have no plans to die. I don't know those who plan to die, but me, it's not in my plans at all. It's not an amen issue, it's a matter of I don't need to die. It is not faith in it, and I'm not talking faith. The reality of it is we are dying because we do not have access to drugs. Simple, clear, straightforward.
October 1998, my HIV test came out positive. And for about 4 years after that period, I really couldn't do anything about HIV because I couldn't talk about my status, my positive status. I couldn't seek for help. I couldn't do anything. All I knew was what the TV said, AIDS kills. And then the silence, the fear, and the shame that made me unable to talk about HIV was driving me crazy. I had to choose between my sanity and the sham of a life that I had. And I really had to live my life because I got to a stage where I got to understand that, hey, Rolake, wake up, girl, you are important. And this is the only life you have. You don't have another one. You wouldn't get a second chance. Is this or nothing? When I came back to Nigeria from South Africa, I was in South Africa for 3 months. I came back with so much zeal and so much fire. And the treatment action campaign is mind-blowing. It's amazing, you know. And what Zaki and the other guys had done in 4 or 5 years, I wanted to do in 4 or 5 months. And things just never work that way. I realized that the next stage is not the fight. The next stage is the work, educate the people. Today I'm talking about what I call the twin brothers from hell, their stigma and discrimination.
Okay, so then what then is treatment advocacy? Treatment advocacy is for us raising issues about treatment, raising awareness about treatment, and what are the issues surrounding treatment that we need to push for.
Checked actually. I think I'm 3 months late for this appointment.
Really?
I'm not very good with adherence. I'm not very good with drug taking. I can't afford to start and not be able to commit to it. So just having to take meds every day means there's something wrong, like a constant reminder of this virus. I'm just not in a hurry for the meds, really. I'm not.
And this is really the best time to start antiretroviral therapy. Huh? Mine can affect the city for don't cry. there are so many things that can affect the CD4 count. You've been under stress. And you know we discussed this thing the last time, in January. Huh? We discussed it.
Varamune and Corn Beaver, that's what I have. Do you have, can I change them to anything that's generic? I prefer generic. I don't want these ones. No, I don't. I believe that PEPFAR should be doing generics. Because they need to help bring down the practice of these drugs. I mean why I believe so is obvious now. I mean there's no point. What I have in my hands, right, for 1 month would give somebody treatment for 5 or 6 months. Yes.
We demand that we should have treatment in every single state of this country.